Hello, my name is Luther Jenkins, and this is the Basic Aerodynamics Research Tunnel, also known as BART. It's very important for us to use wind tunnels. They actually simulate the conditions that these vehicles are going to experience, which allows us to examine some of the fundamental details of the airflow over a vehicle. And it has a host of experimental and measurement techniques that will allow us to really gain some great insight and understanding, as well as look at the performance. So let's look at the wind tunnel. This is the entrance of the wind tunnel. This is where the air actually comes in. And the fan is actually downstream, pulling the air over the model, which is kind of interesting when you think about it. It's kind of like a vacuum cleaner. As the air comes in, it's usually not flowing nice and straight, which we want it to before it goes over the model. So we actually have these screens that we use to break down the little small eddies in the flow and allow it to flow nice and smoothly before it goes into the test section. Here in the test section, if we're running at full speed, the air is traveling at 125 miles per hour. So our models will be positioned here in the test section and the air will flow over it. And then we use our different techniques to actually make our measurements. One of the things that we actually employ quite a bit of is lasers. The lasers allows us to actually visualize the flow over the model, as well as measure the speed and the direction of the airflow. In this situation, we have our lasers and our cameras mounted on the traverse system. And the traverse system wraps around the test section, and it moves as one big cube. And then we can position it around the model at different locations. It can move a meter in that direction, a meter in this direction, and a meter in the vertical direction. And then we have our cameras looking at those regions, and we can either image those regions, or we can actually take images that will then allow us to determine the speed and the direction of the air. There's also an additional laser system on the top that you can see here, and it's projecting a light sheet down through the ceiling. So we can look at the flow in multiple, and basically like an MRI machine, we can dissect it into various pieces to examine it. Now BART is either a single operator or maybe a two-person operation. So most of the time, it only takes a technician and an engineer to actually do some of the outstanding work that's done here. Now BART is an open return wind tunnel. So the room which surrounds the tunnel actually serves as the return circuit and allows the air that flows out of the fan to make its way back to the inlet. So NASA has an expression. They say that BART is a workhorse that never quits. So thank you for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.